Do you have trouble finding common bank reconciliation mistakes? Well, during this fourth consecutive month of bank reconciliation, we will be discussing the most commonly made mistakes and how to find and fix them. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Common bank reconciliation mistakes can be broken into two categories: mistakes that we cannot see and mistakes that we can see. A mistake that we cannot see would be a check that cleared on the bank statement that we failed to record into QuickBooks. And the more challenging mistake that we cannot see is when we clear the wrong check because it has the same money amount as a check that did not clear. Now, we will address those in one moment, but the good news is there are mistakes that we can see just by looking carefully. For example, if the same transaction in both places has a transposed number, if we look carefully, we can find that difference. If the change column is wrong, because very often people who record transactions quickly sometimes leave out the cents or leave out the change at the end of the number. And the last mistake that will be available for our eyes is when the money amount winds up in the transaction number field and the transaction number winds up in the money field. These are things that we will address one by one right here in this video. First, let's remind ourselves of the process. During the month, we are recording the same transactions that the bank is recording, and then we do bank reconciliation and establish a cleared balance. But if you clear the wrong checks because it has the same money amount, what you will have is a check that should be cleared that isn't, and a check that is cleared that should not be. Let's imagine that check number 75 is cleared and should be, and check number 61 to Rex Repair is not cleared and should not be. But if you make the mistake and you accidentally cleared check 61, and did not clear check number 75, that means check number 61 is part of the cleared balance and check number 75 is not. Now, what if the top text here does happen? What if Rex waits too long and check number 61 needs to be voided and issued again to Rex? Well, now, wait a minute. If you void this check, that means that you're voiding something that's part of the cleared balance, and you're not supposed to do that. How could a cleared check never be deposited? Well, that's how you know you have this mistake. What's the solution? The solution would be just clear check 75 and unclear check number 61. Once you found the mistake and found the transaction with the same money amount, you'll be able to do this the way we showed in the register window in a previous video. Then, if we actually, let's see it twice, because that was a lovely bit of animation. Now, you may ask yourself, why are we voiding a cleared check? Well, we must have cleared the wrong check for the same money amount. If you look for the check with the same money amount and then clear that check, you should unclear the wrong check. Then you could void the check that's really uncleared and go ahead and resend it, and you don't have to worry about messing up the cleared balance. Now, what about this other mistake that is not immediately apparent? There's a clear check on the bank statement that was not recorded into QuickBooks. Well, first, you have to find the physical check or deposit slip for the deposit or check that's on the statement that you did not record in your QuickBooks Online records. If it's legitimate, just enter it. That's all you have to do. Leave the bank reconciliation window, go and enter the transaction that you forgot or failed to record, then go back to the bank reconciliation window and continue reconciling. But if you try to look at the check or try to look at the deposit slip for something that's on the statement but not in your QuickBooks Online records, then it might not be legitimate. If not, call the bank and discuss the wrongful transaction that has been charged to your account on the statement that you are reconciling. Have them recorrect it and then, of course, send us a corrected statement. And that would be the way to address the issue of something on the bank statement that's not legitimate and we should not record in our QuickBooks records. You may well note the fact that it is the bank reconciliation process that helped you find that incorrect charge. What I can give you practice with are mistakes that your eyes can see. For example, a transposed number for the same transaction on the bank statement as well as in QuickBooks Online. Or a transaction that's missing change or has the wrong number in the cents or change column. As well as a transaction where the money amount is in the transaction field and the transaction number is in the money field. Those are things that we can practice on April's fourth consecutive month bank reconciliation. So I'm going to give you practice finding and fixing. Go ahead and open the sheet named Incorrect April Bank Statement. Try to find the three mistakes mentioned by doing the reconciliation matching process. After you find all three mistakes, you should open the sheet named Corrected April Bank Statement. Edit what you have done already in the April rec and complete the April bank reconciliation with the corrected statement. And don't forget, when you start using the corrected statement, you have to click Edit and update the ending balance for the correct ending balance for the new statement that you're using. Now at this point, you should pause the video and try doing the April bank reconciliation. Find the mistakes first, then after you've identified the mistakes, go ahead and reconcile. If you found all three mistakes on the bank statement and finished April reconciliation, you do not need to watch the rest of this video. I will now reveal the answer and demonstrate April's bank reconciliation. And the three mistakes on the incorrect bank statement are, in row 8, check number 19 should be $30. Instead, it says this is check number 30 for $19. So that's one mistake down. The next mistake is in row 14. This is $350 even. For some reason, the data entry person at the bank put in $350.35. And the last mistake is here in row 22. The mistake is the transposed number. Check number 20 is not $2,100. Check number 20 is $1,200. But instead, the bank took $2,100 from your account instead of $1,200 like it was supposed to when we refunded Candy. So the bank basically stole the difference between $2,100, which they did take, and the $1,200 that they were supposed to take. So go ahead and open the corrected statement, and now let's do the April bank reconciliation together. So here we are in the corrected statement with the numbers changed back to the way they should be. And in QuickBooks Online, we'll click the cogwheel, and we'll go over to reconcile. Now, you probably will click resume reconciliation. What you'll have to do is you'll have to edit the ending balance in the place I'm about to show you. But I'm putting in the ending balance for the first time. And we're going to come over here. And obviously, the ending date is the same as the last ending date plus 1 month. So instead of typing it in, well, April only has 30 days, so... Here we go. Now, I'm going to click Start Reconciling, and we see we have the difference, but what you would have to do if you were doing the corrections and putting in the wrong statement, you would have to click Edit Info and put in the adjusted and corrected ending balance from the new bank statement that you just received after complaining to the bank about those three mistakes. Now we can go one by one and mark off everything that has cleared. Remember the procedure. The safe thing to do is just highlight this in the bank statement. What was it? Oops, it was 2660. And then mark it off in QuickBooks. And only if it's marked off in QuickBooks, come back and mark off the item in the bank statement. Okay, let's see if I can do that. And you can fast forward the video. 18 is $30. Check 18 is $30 here. Good. Let's see. 19 was also $30. Don't want to confuse those. What if one clears and the other one doesn't? Like we talked about. Now we have the 6,000. Okay, well, we'll mark this. Oh, excuse me. We're supposed to mark these off. Now, what about this $6,000? Highlight in Excel, check it off in QuickBooks, and then mark it off back in Excel. Let's examine this $120. Yes, it's here. So we will mark it off on the bank statement. Okay. What about this $100 to Staples, check number 61? Yep, no problem there. Okay. What about Rex Repair? Check 62 for 250. It's in QuickBooks Online for the same amount, so we mark it. Now, what about UPS 150? Check 65. Yep. See, they do not clear in the same order. That's the lesson of the bank statement. Staples, check 63 for 350. Yes. So we come back and mark it off. What about Verizon, 895? Okay. Scroll down a bit. Yep, there we go. And mark it. Okay. What about 150 to UPS? There it is, a deposit. Okay, and if it's the same in the bank statement, we mark it. 4,300. Okay, that's a deposit of several customers' payments. That's why it says split. But it's the same in both places, so there's no issue here. 400, a check to Rex Repair, looks the same in both places. Con Edison, the $1,000, that's probably a refund. Let's see. Yep, that was the refund from Con Edison. Staples, a check for $833. Mark it in the bank statement. We're almost done. We're ready for the grand finale. 500 Reese's Repair Shop on that very special day, 420. Okay. What else should we mark off? How about change it to blue? Mark off 420. Okay. The 1200 that we corrected is still here, but this time it's correct for check number 20. So this time we'll mark it off and we saved ourselves some money there. Getting down to the end, $1,700 deposit from Verizon, that also was probably a refund. $425, well, we only got a couple more, $725 from Staples, there it is. Notice there's only a $50 difference now, and we're getting down to the wire with two left. Now we have one left after this $500 that we mark off here, and the difference is $450, so let's acknowledge in the bank statement. Now, there's a $450 difference up here, and one left for $450 down here. So at the moment, only at the moment that we mark this off, only at the moment the very last one is marked in the bank statement and matched in QuickBooks, that's the moment that we are finished with a zero difference. Now we can click Finish. We can browse our reports and see exactly what was the condition of all the categories of transactions in the entire QuickBooks Online account for this bank account at the moment we did April's bank statement.